There will be new, more comfortable trains. Lower floors with a single step for easier access. Facilities for wheelchairs and buggies, and a baby changing area and extra space for bikes.
It's a look into the not-so-distant future for train travel between Brighton and Bedford. This, what will greet passengers on their commute as Thameslink unveiled their rolling stock. Hundreds of Class 700 carriages will replace dated trains, which have come to the end of the line after being used in service for decades. The new carriages will increase network capacity by 27%, with an extra 1,000 seats. They will include real-time onboard travel information to make journeys and connections more accessible. There will also be free Wi-Fi on board to allow passengers to be better connected. But on a line that has seen so many problems over the past few months, do passengers feel new carriages will make a difference to delays?
Well, they ought to. It depends what the delays are caused by, but they ought to, yes.
Yeah, and you can only get so much capacity on a train, so you need more trains as well. But in general, yes, it's got to be.
And the comfort factor has to be taken into consideration. If you're more comfortable with your delay, it's better than uncomfortable.
I mean, there has been a decrease in the amount of delays over the past year in comparison to past years before that, but I'm not too sure that new trains equal no delays.
Yeah, I feel like if there are delays, having more obviously would probably help it out. I welcome it.
Yes, new trains, definitely. I think otherwise a broken down train caused a huge hold-up on the whole of the system. So new trains and also maintenance. They must have any new trains are complicated. They've got to be maintained correctly.
All of the carriages will be on track in 2018 as the multi-million pound Thameslink programme comes to an end. And even if there are still delays, at least these new trains will hopefully provide a comfy place to wait. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.